Cars are right at home in California studios, and this Rolls-Royce belongs to the man who reshaped television by spinning game shows into an American institution.
You enter, Mystery Challenger, and sign in, please.
Mark Goodson's games proved you could still have fun, give away prizes, and have class. What's My Line and his follow-up winners propelled him to the status of very rich, but didn't automatically bring happiness.
I have been in my life, had times of enormous unhappiness. It would have been worse if I hadn't had things going for me that would keep me economically with my head above water.
Even giving away more than $50 million, his money spins in from The Price is Right, Tattletales with Burt Convy, and the biggest hit of all, Family Feud.
When you get clobbered with an emotional blow in your life, being rich doesn't help a lot.
But it helps a little. We'll be right back to find out how Mark spends his millions in Los Angeles and at home in New York when Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous continues.
5D, and it's take one.
Try to give it with as much authority as you can.
No matter what you're doing, make it sound like you did.
I guess I discovered that I had a knack for games. And I think I gave to game shows a kind of intensity of effort that up to that time had only been given to drama and things of that sort.
When game show filming moved from New York in 1972, Mark Goodson simply rented a permanent suite at one of the world's most expensive hotels, gutted the place, and remodeled it to his liking.
The other day, I opened the door, and you get a nice view of this colorful apartment. And I saw a man and woman pause for a second, and she said, "Darling, next time, let's get this one." Well, I decorate in a very strange way. The objects are what make a room. The thing that makes a room are the things that a person goes out and says, "That's mine, I like that."
The multimillionaire gave himself an unlimited budget, so his homes on both coasts are filled with priceless art. But his favorite is the Picasso collection, which seems to be everywhere.
In my dining room, I have Picasso again in silver. He did the four silver plates that are on the red wall. Those were the first things I ever got. I like them a lot. Each room has a kind of character and really a different color. This room, which is my study, is basically green. My living room is a brilliant blue. And this media room that you asked me about, I decided to make black and white. Everything really that is connected to my career in broadcasting, and it has a large screen that drops down.
Do you keep identical sets of belongings in both places, or is your lifestyle completely different depending on which coast you're on?
I have a set of shirts here and a set of shirts there, a set of suits here and suits there. And I get on the airplane with just a briefcase. It may sound silly, but I also... I have a great laundress in New York. This one is so great in New York that I've decided I take the shirts that I wear, pack them up, send them Federal Express back to New York. She launders them, back they come all packed, and I utilize my New York staff to do that.
The good life wasn't always so. Raised during the Depression on a bankrupt chicken farm, Goodson is a true rags-to-riches story.
I never owned a suit of clothes until I was maybe 20. I was very poor. My parents were both immigrants from Russia. And my mother, who is in her 90s, who lives in California and is totally secure, still cannot bear to part with a dollar. My urge, my motivation, was never to be rich. I never thought I would be. It was not to be poor.
In spending money to make money, Mark went through a series of stages dealing with success.
First, money meant security. And then money goes on to mean semi-luxuries. Car, nice clothes, a decent place to live. Then I think money becomes bigger luxuries. Art, a better car or more cars, an extra house. And I think ultimately, and I don't know if I've reached that stage yet, but ultimately, money then becomes, in a strange way, no longer things you can buy, but a part of your identity and a kind of power. And I think that all the... See, people will talk about money with a certain amount of freedom. And they'll say, I have this, and it's worth so much. But almost no one is ever willing to admit that he wants power. It is one of the... And I suggest you do your next series called Power.
Success is a power Goodson hasn't abused, giving back to his industry through charities, scholarships, and donations, like this valuable screening theater for the American Film Institute.
I see no moral reprehensibleness whatsoever in success. Your attitude of success is something different. I think if you act like a man to whom the world owes a living, and if you walk all over people, then I think success is bad. I think if you're generous with your success, I think if you are modest about your success, I think it's terrific.
Mark Goodson, successfully at peace with his mogul millions, forged from childhood foundations.
Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous.